At the beginning of this chapter, I mentioned that we will often find a simpler algebraic way to solve our problems, such as using the fact that a state is an eigenstate of an observable instead of applying calculus. Well, simpler is a bit of a relative term. To find the concrete starting point can require us to be very creative. But once we have this, such algebraic pictures can offer very different insights and indeed suggest very useful physical pictures. And there is really no system in quantum mechanics for which this is more true than for the harmonic oscillator. The method that I show you now is incredibly compact and leads to a language that is widely used to formulate quantum mechanical systems in practice. Indeed, what we develop here is a key ingredient of the language to describe fundamental elementary particles, such as photons, as well as a host of effective excitations in much more complicated systems, to which one can assign a particle-like nature, with lattice vibrations leading to the concept of a phonon, just one example. Our inventive starting point is to combine the operators for position and momentum into a single object, given here as A. Very weird, you may think, if you replace the operators in there by real numbers, this gives you a complex number. Indeed, these objects are not observables. But as a matter of fact, they mirror a very compact mathematical description of the harmonic oscillator in classical mechanics, which is based on complex numbers. We won't need this classical picture here, but if you are interested in this, something really nice happens if you calculate the derivative with respect to time of this object in the classical theory. In any case, this suggests to also introduce a second object, denoted here by A with a dagger, which you can view as the complex conjugate of this. It's really the Hermitian conjugate that we introduced just before with our general notation. This language simply reflects that we do not deal with numbers, but with operators. When we introduce these operators, we liken them to matrices, and our general notation emphasizes this analogy. And as we encountered there, this analogy is further highlighted when we work out the product of these objects. When we multiply out the terms, we need to be careful because, just as for matrices, the order of multiplication now matters. And what we get here looks very promising. The first two terms just look like the Hamiltonian of the harmonic oscillator. There's still a difference, but this difference actually looks somewhat familiar. It indeed involves the commutator of position and momentum, which we just showed equals IH bar. So we get two features out of this, the commutator of these two new operators, which just turns out to be one, and a new way to write the Hamiltonian. Actually, we have two choices, but I write down here is the standard choice of ordering these operators. Now, if you think of it, written like this, the Hamiltonian almost looks like the eigenenergies that we expected to find. They result when we would replace this combination A dagger A by a non-negative integer n. So we anticipate that this has a set of eigenstates with eigenvalues n. As a matter of fact, these should just be the states that we determined by the other method. But we will show this here in a completely different way. Therefore, we give the states a very abstract name. This is just a placeholder for the actual eigenstates written in our general notation. This labels the states by their eigenvalue n, but we really still need to show that these are indeed integers, also in this way to arrive at a solution. In any case, because this will soon turn out to be true, I can already tell you that this combination, A dagger A, has a very intuitive name of the number operator. So now the real magic happens when we apply these operators A and A dagger to a known eigenstate, which we assume to be normalized. First, let us work out the squared length of the new state, for which we use the scalar product. Now, by our definition, this really involves the Hermitian conjugated operator A dagger, and so we get the number operator acting on one of its eigenstates. So, given that the original state is normalized, we just get the eigenvalue n. Next, we apply the number operator to this new state. And by just proceeding algebraically and using the commutator, we find that this is also an eigenstate, but with the eigenvalue n minus 1. So now we have determined what the operator A does to a known eigenstate. We can follow exactly the same steps when we apply a dagger to such a state. And then we first find that the new state has the squared length n plus 1 and turns out to have an eigenvalue n plus 1. So we can write it like this. So these operators A and A dagger relate the different eigenstates to each other, and because you can think of the eigenvalues as steps on a ladder, they are also known as ladder operators. But so far we have only fixed the spacing of the rungs. The final step is to utilize that the squared length obtained above can never be negative. So the ladder must terminate when we climb it down. And this is only possible if it stops at a state for which A times the state vanishes. But according to the precise relation between the states, this fixes n equal to 0 for the lowest state, and hence n runs over all non-negative integers. So going back to where the number operator appeared in the Hamiltonian, we recover the energies that we already obtained in the previous solution. To obtain the corresponding wave functions, we now simply convert the termination condition for the state with n equal to 0, the ground state, into a differential equation. So only now we have to use our definitions of these operators. And the differential equation that we have here is actually much simpler than the Schrödinger equation, because it is of first order and can be integrated immediately. And the solution is simply the Gaussian function that we encountered before. So from here we can apply the corresponding explicit expression for a dagger to climb up the ladder and calculate the wave function of the excited states recursively by applying derivatives. And because this involves just the chain and the product rules, this just gives you the Gaussian multiplied by polynomials, which are exactly the Hermite polynomials. Indeed, this simply boils down to the expression that I gave you to generate these polynomials mathematically. So we obtained the complete solution of this problem and needed to solve a much simpler differential equation only once. The operators A and A dagger are used in many other settings, for instance in quantum optical systems in which photons interact with matter. In this context, the operator A destroys a photon of energy h bar omega, and A dagger creates such a photon, while the number operator counts the number of photons. Because of this, A is then called an annihilation operator, and A dagger a creation operator. So what we have done here really has three purposes. We got some practice with our notation, used it to derive a complete solution of the harmonic oscillator by purely algebraic steps, and found that the objects that we encountered suggest a very concrete physical interpretation which carries over to many other physical situations. Now, in the previous segment, we also saw that this general language unifies a lot of our problems and leads to very general relations. So let us now see how this language helps us to formulate the general framework of quantum mechanics.